We have, of course, Abhay. Abhay Hanjura, it's a great pleasure to be on a fireside chat with Abhay and learn about his journey to unicorn in a record time. In fact, Licious is like the first D2C food brand. And it'll be great to ask a few questions so he can share with the people what it takes, what it is to build a strong brand as a peer from his industry. I'm sure we should have an enlightening thing, and we hope you guys have some good takeaways too. Abhay, how does it feel being here?
I'm here in a public sort of conference after a while, so that's why I was carrying my mask. I was wearing my mask all this while. I just took it off. Thoda dar ke, so feels good, but thoda sa dar lag raha hai. COVID na ho jaye, aise nikal ke. But thanks for having me here. I'm very excited on a serious note.
In case if you're tested, please don't blame me, because I'm the closest to you right now.
आप जाके बॉम्बे जाके आप पक्का चेक कर लेना.
Great. So you know, I have a set of few questions for Abhay, and obviously Abhay is in this mythical category of a unicorn, and kudos for that. You know, I guess times have changed where your unicorns are being churned out in 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, as spoken before. So Abhay, I mean, how was this journey for you, right? I mean, was this like, you know, as children we dream of something, we want to do something, we want to be an engineer, a doctor. I mean, being an entrepreneur is like unheard of, right? But then you want to do something, you want to make a difference. So how did Licious spring up for you, or this whole idea of changing the seafood and meat space, or working in the seafood and meat space? Was it a dream? Was it by default? I mean, what would you like to share with us?
Actually, aisa kuch nahi hai. So I don't have a fancy story. I wanted to be a truck driver when I was, you know, a little kid. So that's what I wanted to do. Then I figured that, you know, there's something more exciting than that, and that was, so I went to an army school, and then I wanted to be a Fauji. That's the only thing I wanted to do. And then I fell in love with somebody who was older than me, and she was already doing engineering. So I could not go to Hindi. So I came here to Bangalore. So look, I really didn't ever dream that, you know, I'd be here, sitting here, you know, telling people about entrepreneurship. But I guess there's a time in your life where, at least to me, it happened when I was about 27 years old, when I hit the glass ceiling in my life. So the good or the bad thing that happened to me is that in my naukri, I made a lot of money. Paisa, gaadi, auda, sab kuch mil gaya. So wo jaldi, when you get a lot of these things early, then I think you also kind of grow out of it quickly, and the diminishing returns had started for me. Incidentally, Vivek was a good friend. He was at Helion Ventures, which is a venture capital firm, one of India's early venture capital firms, and we were friends. So because I hit the glass ceiling early, I was, you know, asking my own self, ki, you know, if you can create so much, you know, of an impact for somebody else, is there a way, you know, for us to create, you know, far greater than impact than, you know, what can generate money or profit. And I think it really started off with that line of questioning of the many things I wanted to do when I was just coming off my last job. And we are Kashmiri Pandits. We have no DNA genes, you know, in business. Our parents get shit scared when we talk about quitting our jobs, and my dad got really scared when I told him I'm going to quit my job. And while I was thinking, so a few things I thought about was wanting to become a stand-up comedian, going to NSD to learn cinema. I also thought that I could set up a small cafe on a hill. So, you know, all of these strange ideas were in my head. But while talking to my dad, you know, something interesting happened. When I talked to him and I told him, hey, Dad, I want to quit my job, he got really scared, and I had to sort of get him a few drinks before he could accept that. And then when he asked me, ki kya karega, and I told him that, hey Dad, you know what, I want to go and make a change in the meat and seafood industry. He actually, you know, got super duper angry with me. In fact, he, you know, he slammed his glass on the table and said that, Mr. Abhay Hanjura, I'm going to publicly disown you if you decide to do this. Right, and I got very shocked, you know, this is an educated IAS officer, you know, he's not some era-gera, you know, and I said, what happened? And he was like, have you forgotten we are Kashmiri Pandits? I said, why should I forget that? Of course, I'm very proud of that. And then he said that, you know, beta, ye to ganda kaam hai, ye to hamara kaam nahi hai, hame shobha nahi deta. I think when my dad said that, something inside me kind of, you know, churned. And I figured that so long as, like, you know, my dad represented a mindset, you know, he represented the mindset of this nation actually. And it's not that Kashmiri Pandits are vegetarians, you know, we are passionate carnivores. So I figured, yeah, there is something wrong. Matlab, why should a category be sidelined, orchestrized, stigmatized? And then as I sort of did more and more work to understand this deeply, I figured that the category had been left behind in stone ages in India simply because of this mindset. And I thought, yaar, wo, matlab, this is a sword, you know, worth sort of putting your neck on the line for, because I think at the end of it, you know, the result of glory, or rather the meaning of glory, could be something really special. So the answer to your question really is this, you know, deep bigotry, this deep hypocrisy was something that I couldn't deal with, and I thought, you know, there's a possibility to sort of change this, you know, for an entire nation. And I think that's what it started off as.
So it's something, the rebellious nature in you probably wanted to go against the norm, which typically entrepreneurs want. So I can easily say it just so happened by destiny and stuff like that.
Excellent.
Fantastic. So you know, now that Licious has grown to this level, obviously it was not born this way. It was all startups are born probably from just founders. So you keep adding people, your organization keeps growing. It would be so interesting to know for the audience is, how do you explain that vision to your first team, and how does that vision keep changing, and how does the organization, do you take any steps so that organization, they grow with the organization, or how do you keep changing your vision, how do you keep getting new people in with more skill sets, better attitudes, or same attitudes, how does that work? That must be a challenge, right? I mean, from 5 people going to 500, 1,000, 2,000, it's an ongoing journey. So how do you, is there any particular method you used?
Yeah, so Sangram, I think that's the biggest challenge of organization building. You know, when you start off, you're a motley crew. So it's the difference is, you know, as explained to me by another entrepreneur beautifully, is that early days is like, you know, being on a sailboat. You know, so 2 or 3 people, you know, you can actually navigate it in different directions. But as you become bigger, you know, the organization becomes like a ship. You can't change the direction of a ship, you know, just by twisting and turning, you know, in few directions. So I think that's the difference in the organization. But I think the way to do this really, and, you know, keep your vision honest, at least what I have been fortunate to learn through a series of experiences and failures also, is that you must try and do 2 or 3 things, simple things. Number one, I don't think vision changes over a period of time. I think your own belief and conviction in the vision, in fact, increases with time. I mean, you set out one day to say, you know what, I'm going to serve millions of consumers. And today when you do this, you think, hey, you know what, I can actually serve billions of consumers. So I think the order and magnitude of that changes, but fundamentally in our mind, the vision that we started with, that look, what Amul did to milk and dairy in India is what Licious will do to animal husbandry and fishery sector, that has remained constant. So number one is, you know, be steadfast on vision, because if you keep changing vision, you start looking schizophrenic. And there are multiple reasons why, you know, there is this vision chaos. Sometimes it's investor induced, sometimes it's, you know, it's growth induced, so on and so forth. But one must try and steer away from that. The other thing is holding on to your nucleus. I mean, the first 5 people, your ability to hold on to them for as long as you can. And it doesn't matter who they are, you know. They don't have to be vice presidents from day one and stay vice presidents till day, you know, 500. I mean, even someone who's a meat technician in your production floor, you know, if someone is, you know, a delivery hero. I mean, I think having early believers in the system really pays off, because those people are also the fountainheads of the truth, because they've seen the organization evolve on that journey. Yesterday, day before yesterday, we completed our, we celebrated our foundation day. And we gave, you know, 5 years, people who spent more than 5 years in Licious, we recognize them. And you'll be very surprised to hear, 100 people have completed 5 years in the organization. Now imagine 5 years ago, company mein kitne log honge? 500 log honge, aaj se 5 saal pehle, utne hi honge. To usme se aaj bhi 100 log hain. So point is ki, when the nucleus is intact, then they become the fountainheads of this messaging, because they've seen, you know, they've seen the results of staying true to the vision. Yeah, so I think that's really, you know, number two. And finally, I think, look, unless there's a price to pay to live a value, and unless you can role model and exhibit that in real life, I don't think any vision comes to life. I'll give you one example. So in Licious we say, hey, you know what, we will never sell what we will not feed our own families and children. I mean, it's simple, right? It makes the meaning of quality simplest to everybody in the organization. But how do you bring it alive? I remember 2017 when we were launching Delhi for the first time. And there was a lot of pressure on the organization. You know, a bunch of folks said, you are one city wonder. You know, Bangalore, mein everybody likes everything with the app. The moment you go to other markets, you'll get killed and so on and so forth. There was a lot of pressure on the organization. The other thing is, paise bhi nahi the. Wo jitne hi humne series A mein paise raise kiye the, wo khatam bhi hone wale the. So if Delhi would have gone bust, we would have gone bust with it. And I remember day one, we had done a Gurgaon Times full newspaper ad. For context, you know, those days, and even today, it's a big money. Kuch 12-15 lakh rupay lete the, us ad ke. And humne plan kiya tha major activation for some massive acquisition. And you know, the morning that we were supposed to basically reap the benefits of this advertising, our QA folks said that, hey, you know what, the chicken that had come in, you know, from our supplier is not processable. And we said, what's the issue? And the issue was that the SOP said that the product has to be received at 0 to 4 degrees. But the product was received at 7 degrees. And the QA folks rejected a 2-ton container, which effectively meant that for the next day, you would go out of stock on entire inventory with which you were carrying your advertising. And not only that, you'll also get the juta from the customer, ki yaar bechna nahi aata to advertising kyun karte ho, right? But, and the whole marketing team was jumping up and down, ki yaar kya, and if people, wise people even gave you advice, ki yaar kya fark padta hai, 7 degree hai, aapke paas itna bada refrigeration hai, andar leo, 2 ghante mein 4 degree ho jayega, ye kya pagal ban hai, right? But we said, yaar, that day, you know, if there's no price to pay to live this value, then this organization will become a charitrahin organization. No matter what I say sitting in Bangalore, nobody in Delhi or Calcutta will believe me. So I think that's the day when we rejected that, the rejection of that container, that 2-ton container, and rejection of that 30-40 lakh rupees of sale on that day was a far bigger message for the entire organization. And from that day to now, you know, it's very clear to the organization what it means. Right? So this is a simple way in making your vision come alive. Otherwise, aap kuch bhi Urdu mein, Hindi mein, Farsi mein bhashan de do, bade conference room mein, kahin pe latka ke likh do ki we are a quality obsessed company, usse koi fark nahi padta.
So it's like what you're suggesting is you have to have a value system.
Absolutely.
At the brand.
Yeah, and you need to live by that value system. Yeah.
Absolutely. That's well said, actually. You know, things are changing today at a warp speed. Patience levels have gone down. You know, things that used to happen over a decade start happening in a year. Things don't wait. Maybe that change started in 2015, maybe in 2014, or it's been ongoing. But in this last 7 years in your journey, I mean, how much has changed, and how is that helpful to you? And what is the situation today right now? And what would you like advise young entrepreneurs, guys who are looking up to brands like yours, who want to have that fabled unicorn status?
Yeah, I think two things are very good. One is, you know, Mota Bhai ne internet solve kar diya desh mein to. खाने को खाना नहीं है बट हॉटस्टार पे मैच देखने को तो है ना तो सो आई थिंक इंटरनेट हैज बीन डेमोक्रेटाइज्ड एंड आई थिंक दैट्स मेड अ बिग डिफरेंस बट सेकेंडली आई थिंक एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप हैज बिकम सेक्सी आई थिंक दैट्स द बिग चेंज दैट आई एम सीइंग कि इन द लास्ट 5 years और हर 5 साल में आई थिंक एक जनरेशन बदल जाती है अभी परसों आर फाउंडेशन डे आई जस्ट फिगर देर आर सो मेनी यंग पीपल इन द कंपनी And the age difference is only 5 years, but मेरे को लगता है हर 5 साल में एक पीढ़ी बदल जाती है So I think the fact that young people, you know, no longer want to confine themselves in the realm of a job or naukri, because naukri mein operating word naukar hota hai, right? And I think aajkal ke logon ko ye naukri khatam nahi hoti. So I think this is a big tectonic shift. You know, the time, I think that time has gone when folks used to go to, you know, pedigree B schools, etc. and say, you know what, main McKinsey mein jaunga, main HUL jaungi, main, you know, Bain BCG karungi. I think that has shifted. I think people are deliberately walking into chaos of the startups because they want to take that experience and then start up, you know, on their own. So I think these two, in my mind, are big changes, which has also made India accepting of, you know, startups. So, you know, different folks in different ways are entrepreneurs. I mean, to see the rise of micro entrepreneurs also, right? Matlab, today you can, like Kirti is sitting here, right? And she, I know for a while, you know, and I've seen her journey. You know, she's in her own way doing advocacy for plant-based food, right? And she has a followership. Right? Imagine, you know, and this is sexy, this is cool now, you know, somebody is listening to this. Talk to me 6 years ago, people would be like, kya yaar, tum apna naukri chhod ke kya time pass kar rahe ho, right? So I think that has changed. And in my mind, I think that's a big, you know, big shift. So the advice to, look, I am nobody to, you know, share any advice, but I think all I can tell everybody is that this is the best time to embrace chaos. This is the time of India. This is the time, you know, for us to make a mark in the world, because, you know, we are no longer seen as, you know, made in India, so, you know, kuch gadbad hoga. In fact, you know, I know that global companies are now taking inspiration from the likes of, you know, us and our sector to say, can this be replicated? What Licious has done, what companies like yours have done, you know, can this be replicated at scale in the globe, right? So India is now the shining example of innovation for the world. So India mein abhi bahar ka copy paste solution nahi chalega. So jo India mein hoga, wo India ke liye authentically hoga. So, you know, build for India, make for India, believe in yourself. This is the time. I think that's all I can sort of share with this group here.
Sure, just adding to this. So yesterday I was just sitting with somebody who was very senior in HR, with a big brand, established brands in the last 40, 50 years. And he was actually telling me his pain points that today the youngsters don't have patience. You know, they want to move quickly. They want to make an impact too soon. You recruit so many youngsters. And I think youngsters are the future. You know, I'm completely with that. Does it irk you anytime? Or do you think something could change out there where you want them to put in a little more time, a little more effort, or the world can't be captured within a day? Or what are your views on that? Because these are conflicting views between old brands and now the way new technology has come. It'll be very interesting for the youngsters also at least to grab that advice from you, or your opinion.
Again, you know, the big change that has happened in our lives and the way the life has changed in the last decade or so is just internet and technology has, if you were to draw now, you know, human evolution chart, to pehle wo ek aise jhuka hua hota hai, phir wo danda pakade khada hota hai, phir wo seedha khada hota hai, phir wo chalne lagta hai. Abhi mereko lagta hai ek haath mein aisa phone hoega ya ek haath mein phone hoga aur banda kuch kar raha hoga times. So I think ye jo duniya hai, is duniya mein aaj aap aur main agar yahan hai na, to hum yahan aur kahin aur bhi hain. And I think technology is allowing us to do that effectively. So because this generation has not seen what we have seen, I think they are used to this world. And I think instead of asking them to become, you know, more patient, waqt lagta hai, dhyan se kar lo, I think we need to adapt to, you know, this mind to say ki yaar, what can we learn from this mindset so we don't become irrelevant. Main to thoda ulta sochta hu ki dekho, jo cheeze, you know, ek time pe 10 saal lagte the jo karne mein, agar aaj wo 3 4 5 saal mein possible hai, to I think we, instead of asking, telling people ki yaar nahi ye kaam karo kyunki XYZ brand 10 saal mein bana hai, humko 7-8 saal mein banane ki koshish karni chahiye. I don't think, you know, that's the way to think about it. I think the way to think about it is, you know, asking these people, okay, tell us how and why you think that this is possible faster, while operating in a world of guardrails, you know. So which is basically freedom within a framework. Ki yaar, theek hai, we are an organization that makes and choices, so I'm happy if we can go for a 3x growth, but not at the expense of unit economics and let's say, you know, a couple of other things. Then you push that hard problem back to that whoever person you're talking about, the youngster, and you know, you'll be surprised and shocked to see the quality of solutions that people come up with. So I think what is non-negotiable for you needs to be called out very clearly early on, saying, yeah, I'm okay to play this game at whatever speed you want to play this game, but I will play fair, I will not sledge, I will not cheat, whatever, right? I mean, whatever is your code of conduct, what you believe in. And I'm sure people can know how to operate freely within a framework.
I think that's an amazing takeaway, right? Freedom within the framework. I thought that is quite an interesting answer. You know, just yesterday I was at a panel at IIM Bangalore, and we had some really established FMCG brands, right from all the layers to, you know, of course, Big Basket is a startup, but no longer a startup, it belongs to the Tata Group, the Snowmans, and all the players. And there was a common thing, there's a common thread that everybody spoke about in the food business. And it's all about fusing all the speed, the technology, the human resource, by a common thing called culture. You know, culture in an organization. How challenging is it for you, or how do you maintain that since you are actually growing at this kind of a speed? You know, unicorn within 5 to 7 years is an amazing achievement. But has it been tough for you to keep that culture intact? You got people coming from all sides, different cities, expansion, products, different thought processes. So how do you manage to keep that culture intact? Because most of these big brands, in a common framework on culture, even McDonald's for that matter.
How to, you know, again, you know, people, culture, I think these are the most complex, you know, business problems more than, you know, growth marketing, brand marketing, tech, etc., etc. And it is a challenge. I think, see, for us, our unique challenge is slightly different. Our unique challenge is that we are like 6 organizations in one organization. So on one side, we are a farming company. So deeply agrarian, farming and imports, right? On the other end, we are a processor, right? So manufacturing. Then we have a last mile delivery sort of network, which operates more like a delivery company. And in the middle somewhere, we have these, you know, folks from, yes, you know, market, the best of the FMCG marketeers, you know, the best of the tech guys, product guys, so on and so forth. So I think these are a few organizations. So by design, there's a lot of entropy and heterogeneity within the organization. So I think what helps is, again, you know, having a set of values, you know, coded, encoded, you know, within the organization's framework and making it very simple. I mean, you can have a very complicated value system and people can't, may not be able to understand what it is. Like I said, you know, how do you make quality fixation simple for everybody? By just saying that, hey, we will not sell what we will not feed our families, right? So this is what it means, right, for the people. So number one is this. Second is, I think for us, we struggled on this whole dimension really during COVID, because what COVID did is COVID separated people and it put people, you know, from Jumritalaya to Jammu to Trishur, you know, working from there. And because we grew so much also in the pandemic, we had 60%, 70% of the organization recruited in the pandemic. So I think what we were missing as an organization is this, you know, back thumping, looking into each other's eyes, you know, talking to each other vulnerably. People were going from one meeting to the other and then, you know, going back to their kids, their parents, so on and so forth, right? So there was this no natural connection and chemistry getting built within teams, within leaders, within peers. I think that was something that we really struggled with. And I think what helped us really sort of at that point in time was just over communication. So what we did is that if in a physical setting, if we were to sort of get together, say, you know, 4 times a year, here we were doing it once in a fortnight. So, you know, town halls every 15 days, you know, to keep reiterating where the organization is going, you know, what value is important for the organization, which team has demonstrated the, you know, the value that's important for the organization. So I think over communicating the same thing again and again and again and again, you know, is very important. And what I've learned is that, and this is what, you know, many people tell me, Abhay, whenever you speak about, you know, Licious, you speak with so much passion. How do you do it? You say this so many times, you know, you must have said this 5,000 times already in your life. And what I tell them is that, look, I may have said this 5,000 times, but let's say today is the 5,001st time. There's still, let's say there's a possibility there are 20 people sitting in this room who have never heard me before, right? And for them, it's extremely important on my part to keep saying the same thing because they've not heard it, right? So that's true for the organization also. When you go from 50 to 500 to 5,000, today we have 7,000 people, you know, the latest batch of 100 has not heard you, right? So I think this over-communication, keeping it simple, repeating this, I think sometimes there's a lot of magic in monotony. People try to, you know, make things sexy by just complicating it. But the I think harder thing is to do the same thing again and again and again and again. But nobody wants to do it. Why? It's boring. Kya har baar wahi baat karte rehte hai? Arey yaar, wahi, that is who you are, right? So I think that's important.
Well, that's interesting. So monotony, more practice, bring the message across the hierarchies and stuff. That's pretty cool. You know, as Licious, I mean, you have a long way to go. The market is so big. You know, you're talking about global markets also. But as entrepreneurs, everybody's got to be paranoid to an extent. You know, we all are paranoid. We all worry about things. Some may not. What worries you most in the next 5 years when it comes to your business?
Yeah, what worries me most is that, is the day this will become a business to me? So I think that's my greatest worry. Abhi tak to nahi hua hai. So this is like my, I'm like Alice in Wonderland. And I think that's what keeps me going. The day this becomes a dhanda, I think that'll be the beginning of my end. So that's what I worry about.
But I'm sure you're on the journey. I'm sure you'll get there because I think your core values are intact. That's more important.
Yeah, absolutely. See, what I mean is, the moment you start thinking about something, see, what I'm not saying that you should not think about the reality of a business, but sometimes just thinking about it only as a business, you know, takes away from what you can add or subtract to this. When you just look at it, मैं उसको समझा नहीं सकता हूँ. हिंदी में कहते हैं ना, मेरी नजर से तुम देखो तो यार नजर वो आए, तो मतलब मैं समझा नहीं पाऊँगा. But मेरे लिए Licious एक धंधा नहीं है, मतलब तो बहुत क्लियर है. और उसी से डर लगता है जिस दिन धंधा बन जाए.
It will become, I think you're right there, sir.
Nani yaar, aisa
nahi. You know, what's your advice to, I know you said you're not, you should not be giving advice, but I think you're in the position that you can do a lot of insights and value adds out there. Key ingredients to build a company in 5 years against 15 years?
Yaar, advice to hai nahi mere paas koi. I think what I can request instead, you know, people here is, yaar, ho sake to duniya ki mat suno. Ho sake to, you know, apne dil ki awaaz ko zor zor se dhadakte hue suno. Ho sake to try and be answerable to the only person you see in the mirror. You know, ho sake to mushkil raste pe aaj jao, kal nahi. हो सके तो अपनी किस्मत की डोर अपने हाथ में रखो किसी और के नहीं. तो आई थिंक ये एक रिक्वेस्ट है, ये कोई एडवाइस नहीं है. क्योंकि यार लाइफ में ना ये दिन फिर कभी नहीं आएगा. नौकरी करने के लिए किसी का सूट कोट पैंट जूते पहन के टाई लगा के कहीं रोज एक पीपीटी करने के लिए पूरी दुनिया पूरी ज़िंदगी पड़ी है. मगर अपना सपना जीने के लिए बस आज का दिन है. और अगर इस रास्ते के पीछे आज नहीं गए ना, तो कल जब घुटनों में दर्द होगा और बाल सफ़ेद होंगे, तुम कहोगे यार काश, यू नो, मैं ये करके देखता. तो यार वो रिग्रेट के साथ जीना ना बहुत बुरा होता है. एंड देयर इट्स नेवर टू लेट. मैं तो कहूँगा कि अगर थोड़ा सा घुटनों में अभी उतना दर्द नहीं हुआ है और बाल उतने सफ़ेद नहीं हुए, तो आज भी शुरू हो जाओ, है ना. तो देयर इट्स नेवर टू लेट, यू नो, टू फॉलो योर ड्रीम. ऑल आई कैन रिक्वेस्ट यू, आई कांट एडवाइज यू. I have not done anything to, you know, be an advisor to anyone. So that's what I can say.
Next milestone for Licious, other than making it a business, as you said, if it has to be Alice in Wonderland, then what's your next milestone?
Yeah,
Eka Corn or anything else?
No, yaar, Corn one to hota rahega. It doesn't matter. यार ये जैसे ये बॉटल है इसके ऊपर मैं कुछ भी लिख दूँ, अगर मैं इसमें बिस्लेरी की जगह बोसलेरी, बिस्लारा, हिमलेरी, नीरेरी कुछ भी लिखा हो तो ये हरे रंग की बॉटल हमेशा इस ब्रांड को सिग्निफाई करेगी। ये है कैटेगरी सिनोनिमिटी। आई थिंक ये अगर हमने अचीव किया एज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कि आप जब भी एक यू नो डब्बा देखें तो उसमें आपको एक खुशियों का समंदर देखे और आपका यार मज़ा आने वाला है। तो आई थिंक और ये हमने देखा भी है, हमारी ये कैटेगरी जो काली थैली में थी मीट और सी फूड की छुपी हुई, लोग उसको अखबारों में रैप करके छुपा छुपा के रखते थे, आई थिंक टुडे इट इज़ बींग पैक्ड विद प्राइड। तो माई ड्रीम इज़ द डे यू नो लिशियस कैन टेक यू नो यूबिक्विटी स्टेटस एंड द डे संग्राम you know many more entrepreneurs can prosper and proliferate and grow in this industry. I think that is my and Vivek's dream ki yaar there should be hundreds of Sangrams, hundreds of other entrepreneurs you know who work in the sector to make the sector you know truly thrive. I think that's the success for a category builder. Even Amul built out the category that it did, it didn't get worried here, hey, what will happen if 20, 30, 40, 50, 100 more brands come, it doesn't matter. The market opportunity in India is so massive, it's unbelievable, right? So there's a place for everybody. So I think success will be when the market will move away from Kali Theli and, you know, people will come into the folds of various brands, you know. So I think that is what success will look like.
So Abhay, that was a very interesting answer. I'm sure the market will move the way India is progressing and the way it's going. So that's a pretty cool thing to say. A bit of a question alert here. How would you imagine, hypothetically now going back in time, you know, we're all so proud of your journey and it's a great trajectory, but behind every successful unicorn or the status at which the unicorns are built and recognized, there are probably 1,000 ones that didn't succeed or who blew up before they crossed the karma line. How would you imagine life without being funded by the VCs? Where would it just be today?
I think if we were not funded by VCs, I'm sure we would have been funded by our customers. So I can promise you that we would have raised money from our customers.
Excellent.
And we would have still built what we wanted.
जर्नी
वुड कंटिन्यू हाँ। 23 शहरों में नहीं होते, 8 में होते, कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता। 2 साल बाद पहुंचते हैं, कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता।
सो बट देयर इज समथिंग वेयर इट्स नोवेयर आउट देयर इन द पब्लिक डोमेन अबाउट यू इंडिविजुअली व्हिच यू लाइक टू शेयर बियॉन्ड डिलीशियस।
मैं गाना बहुत अच्छा गाता हूं।
एंड शुड आई से पोएट आल्सो?
हां, वो मैं पहले लिखता था।
प्री मैरिज इज इट?
नहीं नहीं, पोस्ट मैरिज।
सो व्हाट्स अबाय एंटरप्रेन्योर? हाउ वुड यू लाइक टू बी नोन? एंटरप्रेन्योर, बिजनेसमैन, फिलोसोफर, सिंगर, पोएट?
गुड पर्सन है, अच्छा इंसान, दैट्स ऑल।
सो आई थिंक इट्स बीन नाइस हैविंग दिस कन्वर्सेशन विद अबाय। ही हैज शेयर्ड अ लॉट ऑफ वैल्यूएबल इनसाइट्स एंड इट्स अ great journey. I hope you guys have had the takeaways. BW, are we allowed to take some questions from the audience? It would be nice if Abhay can answer.
Hi, Abhay.
Sir, namaste.
Namaste. Very happy to hear from you. My name is Sanjay Sethi. I'm from Plant-Based Foods Industry Association. I recently saw a welcome initiative by you on you started some plant-based products and we were very happy to see that. So I would like to know your so we saw that it's known to everybody, and first of all we welcome that you did that. Second, I would like to know your motivation. How come you went there? Thank you.
So I don't think we have any plant-based products out there in the market as of today. So आपकी जानकारी गलत है सर. But see, what I can answer is this, that what Licious is fundamentally obsessed about is in some sense solving for the massive protein deficit in India. India is significantly protein deficient. 80% of Indians are protein deficient. And I think, you know, on the path that we are on, what is interesting for us is alternate methods of protein delivery, however deeply adjacent to our core category. So we are deeply interested in all forms of alternative proteins, whether it is plant-based, animal-based, because we think that the future, in the future, there, you know, consumers should be given the choice to choose, you know, how they would like to interact with the category. So in that sense, we are very keenly looking at the sector, but we are not in a hurry to take something to the market which is subpar. You know, whatever is out there in the market today in the name of plant-based meat is absolute rubbish. You know, it's not even good for the consumer. Look, the difference between the West and India is this, that West is deprived of good alternative protein choices. India is not, Indian vegetarians and vegans are not missing out on anything. I mean, you look at Kirti's channel, for example, she'll give you, 100 ways to, keep your stomach, palate, conscience happy without making a compromise. So I think Indian vegetarians, I don't know, how many vegetarians do we have in the room? Please raise your hand. See, so many of you, right? So ma'am, you, for example, in the sari, I don't know your name. Are you missing out on a plant-based chicken seekh kebab in your life? No, you're not, right? Any other vegetarian here? Yeah, ma'am in the background. Are you missing out on a plant-based mutton tikki in your life? No, she's not, right? So this is the point. I think vegetarians in India are not looking for this. So whoever is looking for this is also not looking for, you know, a disservice to the word meat. So I think we take our meat origins, we take our meat identity, we take our meat very seriously. And therefore, if ever Licious takes something to the market, it will have to give, active competition to what is actually, our product. So I think we are very invested in looking at this space closely, but sir, we are not interested in taking anything to the market in a hurry, which does disservice to the greater Licious brand and also turns Indians off, alternative protein choice sources. See, the risk Licious runs with a substandard and a hurried sort of entry into the market is that, given the brand that represents the carnivore, it can actually turn people off the category and the sector. So looking at it interestingly, simply because it aligns with our protein vision, but when we take something out, if we do it, yeah, everybody else will thank us. Yes.
I have two questions. One is generic, and you are with the insurance background, so your employees and investors might be buying best insurance.
So my employees and insurers, my employees
your
and
employees
investors.
And investors might be having a best insurance.
100%. Goes okay. Without saying.
Yeah. So second question, what I have is, what is the one advice you can give to the entrepreneurs to raise the funds? One challenge I have been facing is to raise the funds, and I want to create a dent in the universe kind of concept. And I meet investors, and what I hear, first question is, what was yesterday revenue and what is the today's profitability? And I want them to challenge me for the how can I monetize, what is the potential of the idea, how I'm going to build it there, how can I make it a bigger one. Rather than that, most of the times I'll be basing up yesterday's questions. So what is the one advice you can give for the fundraise aspect?
Venkat, the only advice I have for folks in the early in their journey trying to raise funds is, don't be in a hurry to raise funds.
Thank you.
Don't expose yourself to 20 conversations with people when you're not ready for a conversation. Because what that does is that it sets 20 opinions. And those 20 opinions create a 200 people perception in an entire industry. So I think you need to be very measured and calibrated in taking yourself out there. So if the narrative gets built, ki yaar ye to bakwas hai, you know, it's a small community. You know, everybody will say, arre haan, maine to usko dekha tha, ye to bakwas hai. Arre haan, maine to usko dekha tha, ye bakwas hai. So I think don't be in a hurry is my only advice. Focus on, you know, proving out your MVP, focus on proving out your product market fit and a set of metrics that you can go to investors with, you know, with confidence versus, you know, meeting investors almost, you know, 50% of your time and getting discouraged all the time. I'd rather say spend that time in sharpening your sword and go to a few select, you know, set of investors at the right time. Mostly I've seen, you know, people are in a hurry to fundraise because, you know, companies like us have raised so much money, so sabko lagta hai ki yaar paisa uthane se business banta hai. But I don't think, you know, that's the only way to build something, you know, spectacular.
Hey Gaurav, I'm a co-founder.
Hi Gaurav.
Hello. So you did ask a question saying, do vegetarian miss the chicken tikka, the food in the vegetarian thing? We might not miss that, but we do miss the protein content there. So do you think Licious will be getting into that kind of business where protein is given more focus and not the vegetarian, non-vegetarian thing?
I already answered that, you know, for Mr. Pratik here. Yeah. So like I said, you know, so we are looking at it very keenly, and if we do, then we will solve for a wholesome story for sure. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I am Amitabh Satyam from Smart Transformations. I've always wanted to understand about your supply chain and how do you procure and do quality control. So I don't know how much detail, but just a little bit would be fine. And the second one is, do you only do jhatka or do you do both kind, and do you have a separate cold chain for each kind?
I can give you a broad sense, and we don't comment on processing methods. See, this is the Licious business model is built on a fundamental premise that only if you're able to create premiumization and modernization, which is consumer facing, if you can take something from the consumer, only then can you invest it in the supply chain. The supply chain modernization is a direct function of consumerization in a sector. If the consumer is not willing to pay for a X percentage, you know, sourcing cost, Y percentage processing cost, Z percentage cold chain cost, you know, L percentage packaging cost, then the bundled cost of it, you know, if it's no matter how significantly superior the product is, then there's no PMF, right? So fundamentally, this is the model, right? And what we've done over a period of time, and of course with scale, is that we have become more and more vertically integrated. And in the future, you know, Licious can be imagined as a, you know, fully integrated protein platform, animal protein platform that spans across, you know, every single category, with the exception of beef and pork for sure. On the standards that Licious follows, Licious was India's first FSSC 22000 certified meat and seafood player at the time that only HUL and Nestle had that in India. We conform to the highest food safety management systems and standards in the world. We are one of the world's only 8 companies to have the standards in social accountability, in OSHAs, in environmental management systems. So 1 in 8 companies in the world. So I think that's the standard we look up to, not these, you know, standards that have been invented in the country, which sort of polarize, bases some conversation on some jhatka, some halal. This is all, you know, this doesn't matter. What matters is, you know, is this process. So that's what I can tell you, sir, and we're proud to be, you know, doing the work that we're doing.
Hello.
Maybe now you're not facing that, but in your initial years when you were starting off and there were a lot of challenges, that time, were you always getting this feeling ki chhod dete hain, kuch aur karte hain and it's not working? Because I get that feeling every now and then and I just sit back and think, it's not working. So how do you manage that?
Yeah, actually, pehle kam hota tha, ab zyada hota hai. Umar ho gayi hai, you know, I was 27 when I started, I'm 35 now. So I think I had far more energy and resilience when I was younger and unmarried. So, no, but on a serious note, I think, if building organizations was so simple and if it was so straightforward, everybody would have built one, right? I think this is what separates, you know, dreamers from doers, right? I think unless you wake up in the morning and unless your arms hurt and your, you know, back hurts, then you don't know if you're working out and if your muscles are getting built, right? So I think no pain, no gain, yaar, matlab. If you embrace this pain, if you embrace this chaos, if you embrace this uncertainty, ki yaar, raat ko to lag raha hai ki subah tak nahi hoga, but ek drink laga ke so jao, aur subah phir utke, you know, chalo aaj ho jayega. I think this irrational belief of an entrepreneur is what makes an entrepreneur different from an employee, right? Where the entrepreneur believes ki yaar, ye dekho mera jadoo ka khilona, right? I mean, it's almost like what you can see, nobody can see. So that comes with its own pressures here, and I think please embrace this mujhse nahi ho raha and wake up next morning and thoda doodh piyo aur kaam ko chalo, you know. I think that's the way to look at it. Sir,
dealing with the consumer product.
Yes, sir.
Did you got these things, this complaint for the customer?
Of course, sir.
If you get these things, some serious complaint about this thing, because it is life. Sometimes they can give some very typical question. Yes,
sir.
Complaint.
Yes,
how
sir.
You handle that?
So personally, we handle it, sir. We have the biggest team in the company is the customer experience team, you know, it's not a fault-free operation, right? Because you're dealing with perishables, you're dealing with a short shelf life, you're dealing with an intricate, complex supply chain. So, of course, there's going to be consumer complaints, but I think how you handle customer complaints makes a big difference. You know, if you handle them with grace and you handle them with ownership, everything is fine. For example, for the last 15 days, you know, we are going through a manpower shortage in our customer experience team. And as a result of that, we are seeing a lot of abandon rate when consumers are calling us. Now at this time, if somebody is reaching out to our contact center, I think the first thing we are telling them is, you know, we know you've been waiting for 10 minutes to reach out to me and I'm really sorry for that. And the reason for that is that, you know, we are actually running out of staff. What do most companies say? You know, due to a technical reason, your call was not connected. How can I help you? Right? I think sometimes it was just telling the consumer, ki yaar, lagi hui hai, thaka hua hu, nahi aata. Consumer is also a human being, right? Understands. So I think this honesty is what companies miss. They create some jargon, you know, around their inefficiencies due to the technical reason, due to operational delays, due to unforeseen weather circumstances, due to act of God, due to God knows what. Are bhai sach bol do, right? I think this really matters. If you can do it with this, I think you'll be good. You know, honesty and sincerity, bachpan mein padhate the, but mushkil nahi hai, aasan hai, isi liye problem hai.
Yeah, hi, Sohan here.
Sohan, yeah. I love your beard, man.
Thank you. So I wanted to know, Licious is starting in fresh pet foods.
So we have acquired a company last year. It's called Perfectly Made. Yes, so given, you know, so there was a consumer insight here. Most of our consumers are also pet parents. They're very, you know, terribly disappointed with the highly processed food that they're giving to their pets. I think the conversation has changed from pet owners to pet parents. So, you know, keeping the dog tied to a gate to scare the thieves away to now dogs coming and sleeping with you in your bed. I think cats are becoming more like your children. So I think that shift is happening. And yeah, I think we found an interest, a good entrepreneur, a good team. And we've invested in them. And we'll grow this, you know, this fresh pet food business over a period of time. But pyar se banayenge yaar, koi jaldi.
So after this, so are you going to plan for a plant-based as you were asking?
Yeah, sabko plant-based obsession. पहले अपना मैं बिरयानी अच्छे से लॉन्च कर लूँ फिर बाद उसकी बात करेंगे।
Surprisingly, everybody is talking about plant-based, but the demand was just two hands actually. So none, you know, but that's an interesting trend.
Yeah, trendy है इसलिए नहीं करेंगे हम लोग कुछ। This is not that ice bucket challenge कि मेरे साथ भी कर लो। We are not in a FOMO. I think FOMO में सबसे ज़्यादा गलतियाँ होती हैं कंपनियों की। यार भाई वहाँ valuation बन रही है, भाई वहाँ पे किसी को इतने मिलियन मिल गए, भाई वहाँ पे रितेश और जनीले घुस गए, भाई देख कोहली भी खा रहा है, मतलब अरे खाने खा रहा है तो खा रहा है, तब से हंड्रेड नहीं मारी जब से खा रहा है, राइट। तो सो आई थिंक फोमो में नहीं, आई थिंक विद अ साउंड कंज्यूमर लॉजिक यू नीड टू डू व्हाट यू नीड टू डू, एंड इफ यू कैन डू दिस विद अ साउंड कंज्यूमर लॉजिक एनीथिंग, ऑफ कोर्स एनीथिंग द ब्रांड कैन डू।
अभय, वी आर इन कंटेंट स्पेस,
यस,
एंड वी वांट टू बिल्ड सोशल मीडिया कंपनी फॉर अर्ली एज स्टार्टअप्स एंड SMEs, एंड being an early age company, we just want to hear your thoughts. Like in early 6 months, what was your priorities and what things should we all take care of?
First 6 months, our priority was, you know, how to find more space for a processing center, how to find a place to keep people in the office. We were falling off the bed that we were working from. How to open a bank account. So I think there are both primitive problems there. But I think in the early days, you just need to focus on getting the right people on the bus. I think that's all. That's the most single most important thing. You know, it's not as important to have 30, 40, 50 people on the team, you know, than having 3, 4, 5 right people on the team. I think that's the only, you know, advice I can give you. Ki advice bhi nahi request hai sir. Ki ho sake to janta bheed mat bharo, 4, 5, you know, try and get 4, 5, 6, 10, 15. The first 20, 30, 40, 50 people who you bring on board, we personally involved and invested in their hiring process. And I think then you will see magic will happen. That's my only request to you.